find the ammo with it. I pull this back. Okay, it's a little stiff. And then we pull this little gizmo out. Almost did that again. Sorry about that. And this is your buffer back here in the stock. That's right, I didn't have to pull that back. That was a mistake I made. It's a long recoil. And, anyway, any kind of military generally, they try to design it sort of simple to disassemble and to reassemble, to clean everything. This is, by the way, I got this as a, originally as an M60, I think an E1 format. When he got it, it's from the 80s, pretty much. And then he upgraded it. I think it was a Rock Island Armory as the firearm manufacturer. And then he sent it to, it was a Desert Ordnance, I think, and had it upgraded to the equivalent of an E6. This is pretty much the state of the art for an M60 these days. Okay, so it's even used, I think, by the Danish military right now. So it's not totally obsolete. It's, you know, with the upgrades, it's, you know, it's not your old Vietnam era M60 anymore, right? It's a pretty interesting firearm. Once you get the bolt out and everything, you can go up here and push this button. This is what makes these firearms so useful. You just pull the barrel out. See? That's pretty cool. There you go. I think before we let John shoot, we'll take the barrel out. That way you can replace the barrel. You got a handle for it and everything. So that works out pretty well. Pop it back in. Push the clip down. You're ready to go again. I need to bolt out, right? So the M60, even though this is not the Vietnam version of the format, this is kind of an upgrade. It's, you know, back after World War II, the designers were looking for, the military was looking for a lighter machine gun. And this was kind of an, I don't know everything there is to know about it, but it was kind of an attempt to replace both the BAR and the Browning 1919 machine gun. You know, something that would kind of serve those purposes, lighter. You could put on a tripod, you could mount it like they did in Vietnam, you know, on the helicopters and everywhere else. Like that one was mounted on my pickup truck. But it kind of replaced those, and it had some growing pains, and there's a lot of people who have actually, in fact, I used to teach with a fella who was a veteran, and he was a M60 gunner. That's what he did in the military. And there's some real quirks, you know, with the original M60s, but I think generally they work pretty well. But with one of these, you got a lot of upgrades. So in 1952 is when the 308 cartridge came out, and then the military modified it at this point, where not a lot, but it's the 762 by 51 a couple years later, so voila, you've got kind of a replacement for the 30-06. You got a shorter cartridge, then a smaller firearm, a lighter firearm, machine gun specifically, could use. And basically there's not much difference between a 30-06 and a 762 by 51 NATO, you know, especially in military configuration. Now you can load up a 30-06 to where it's hotter for hunting or something, but generally speaking, there's not a lot of difference. And yet you get it in a smaller package, you can make some smaller guns for it. So then this thing came out in the later 50s.